Oh, you can do it better unto Jesus. Give it up to Jesus. Give it up to Jesus. I was glad when they said unto me, I was glad when they said unto me, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go to the house of the Lord. I was glad when they said unto me, I was glad when they said unto me, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go to the house of the, in the house of the Lord.
Hallelujah, joy in the house of the Lord. Hallelujah, joy
in the house of the Lord. In the house of the Lord.
Hallelujah, joy in the house of the Lord. Hallelujah, joy.
Oh, I was glad when they said unto me, I was glad, I was glad, I was glad. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go to the house of the Lord. I was glad when they said unto me, I was glad, so much glad. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go to the house of the, in the house of the Lord.
Hallelujah, joy in the house of the Lord. Hallelujah, joy
in the house of the Lord.
Hallelujah, joy in the house of the Lord. Hallelujah, joy.
Oh, this rain all around me, I can feel it in the latter rain. Right on Jesus to give us more rain
until we are filled and we are soaked in the latter rain.
It is raining,
it is raining all around me.
I can can't feel it.
I can't feel it. In the latter rain.
Right on,
right on, Jesus, to give us more rain. Until we are filled and we are soaked in the latter rain.
It's already better. Things already better. For the Lord is on the throne.
Things already better. Things already better. Things already better.
It's already better.
It's already better.
Things already better.
Things already better. For the Lord is on the throne. Things already better. Things already better. Things already better.
It's already better.
Things already better. For the Lord is on the throne. Things already better. Things already better. Things already better.
We will celebrate our God. We will celebrate our God.
Let His banner be raised and His glory be seen. We will celebrate our God.
We will celebrate our God. We will celebrate our God.
Let His banner be raised and His glory be seen. We will celebrate our God. Let His banner be raised and His glory be seen. We will celebrate our God.
Oh, the Son of Man is coming again.
And the people say, hallelujah.
The Son of Man is coming again.
And the people say, hallelujah.
Oh, say,
hallelujah.
Say,
hallelujah.
Oh, say,
hallelujah.
Oh, say,
hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And the people say, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And the people say, hallelujah. Hallelujah, let the people say, hallelujah.
You can give the Lord a praise.
Forever. And glorify the name of the Lord after the order of John chapter 6 verse 11. Just magnify the name of the Lord in the morning. Give the Lord glory. Whenever you engage yourself in thanksgiving, that means you are doing the will of God. Holy Spirit within you is something more than God. Can you praise God in the moment? And Jesus took the loaves, and when he had given thanks, something just happened. Five loaves of bread and two fishes multiplied supernaturally, fed almost 10,000 people. Can you say a big thank you to God? And as you give thanks to God, do you know what happened to you? Now, you move to the realm of perfection, the realm of multiplication, and the realm of abundance. Just say a big thank you to God in a moment for giving them this great privilege to be in his house. Just worship the Lord. The angels of God are already released in the atmosphere. We are not here alone. We've come to Zion, the city of the living God, with uncountable angels, with the spirit of judgment made perfect. Ladies and gentlemen, just praise God for giving you a gift of life. Lekandara bayandoro bo sataraba ramahataraba ziandoro kata sizilikitibo lemamara kakota la diandahai Jesus, shall we be seated comfortably? Father, we thank you for blessing us by your word. A time with your word is a time with destiny. Thank you, Lord. We believe in thy word, the efficacy of thy word, the washing of thy word. Thank you so much for blessing us in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. Can you snap your hands and give the Lord some praise this morning? We were taken on adventure on a crucial journey about a topic called an example. Very simple topic. An example. Yeah. An example. Well, I hope now we are almost part three of part. Yeah. An example. Yeah. An example. You are blessed in the name of Jesus Christ. And I told you that I gave you the central text from John 13, verse number 15. That was the central text for the topic. An example. For I have given you an example that ye should do as I have done to you. Give me the message version, then we come back to King James Version. I, the Lord, said, I have laid down a pattern for you. What I have done, you do. Let's go back to King James Version. Now, I said something that the easier way to be made, the easiest way to be made is to follow. For I have given you an example that ye should do as I have done to you. Before I push it forward, I'm here to let you know that if you are here of any now promotion, protection, preservation, anything that you need of, now it is available with God. All those things are available with God. I hope I gave it to you last week. Amen. Hallelujah. They are available with God. Amen. Isaiah chapter, when you read the book of Psalm 75 verse 6, Psalm 75 verse 6 will let you know that if you are in need of promotion in any subject matter, on any subject matter or in any department of your life, it is available with God. Your destiny is in the hands of God. And hear what God is saying now. For promotion cometh neither from the east, nor from the west, nor from the south. Look at the seventh verse. Now, but God, Genesis chapter 1, verse 1, for God, in the beginning, God, in the beginning, God created heavens and the earth. So God ought to come first before anything else comes. In the beginning, God created. And here, Bible said that, but God is the judge. He put down one and set up another. May God raise your business up in the name of Jesus. I've been telling you that when God lifts you up like this, no mortal man can bring you down. When you lift yourself up, the law of gravity will drop you down by surprise. But when the Most High God lifts you up, no occultic grandmaster can drop you down. No witch can stop your destiny. Some of you, your case is different. Nobody can bring your destiny down. Hallelujah. But you know what? In the book of Job chapter 39 verse 27, the book of Job chapter 39, shall we read together? 1, 2. Does the eagle mount up at thy command and make her nest on high? Give me Amplified Version. Hallelujah. Does the eagle mount up at your command? All that we know is that when you see eagle soaring in the air, he does it by his wings. That's what you know. But the word of God says that eagle mount up at the command of God. That means that it takes the force of God for eagle, the king of the birds in the air, to fly. And that is why your business is taking another shape after this encounter. May heavens push your business forward in the name of Jesus. May, by the command of God's word, may you move forward and move higher in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So that means that eagle Now, mount up itself at the command of the word of God. Amen. Jeremiah chapter 49, verse 16. The book of Jeremiah chapter 49, verse 16. Then the prophet also says something. Give me King James Version. Jeremiah chapter 49, verse 16. Now, as in the overthrow, Jeremiah, 16. They, thy terribleness has deceived thee, and the pride of thy heart, oh thou that dwelleth in the cleft of the rock, that holdest the heights of the hill, though thou shouldest make thy nest as high as the eagle, I will bring thee down from thence, saith the Lord of hosts. I pray that you will never come down all the days of your life. Let me tell you something. In a crucial time and a moment like this, what we need most is the grace of God. Sometimes you may be very careful of the way you eat, yet something terrible may visit you. The way you drive, yet someone will hit you from behind you. I'm not saying you shouldn't be very careful. It's good to be very careful. But I believe in more grace than anything else. You be so careful of the way you eat, the way you sleep, the way you drive, the way you fly, the way you do. At the end of the day, so careful more than Job. Then something you are afraid of will hit you that you may not even understand. Hallelujah. Last time I was coming and I saw from behind somebody's car a man who had just died 120 years. This is after the order of Moses. I was so happy. Now, I was asking myself, 120 years. Yeah, no, yeah, man, with 120 years. Amen. So I pray for somebody here that the test, this scripture will come to pass in our life. James chapter 4, verse 6. It will come to pass in our life. Grace to live long is given to somebody here right now. Grace to excel is given to somebody here right now. Grace to escape now, plane crash. God is giving to us right now. Grace to escape premature death. God is giving to you right now. The same case to go there. Whilst you were going, you just pick up a cup of water. You drank it. You got there. You said, and you will stand somewhere and say I am what I am by the grace of God. I am strong by the grace of God. I am healthy by the grace of God. I am 100 years old by the grace of God. Hallelujah. So see what he says. But God giveth how many grace? Receive more grace. Oh, grace to prosper is given to you. Grace to shine is given to you. Grace to escape viruses and infections are given to you. Grace to escape premature death is given to you. Grace to escape accident is being given to you. Can you say grace three times? And two, the third one says what? And to your amazement, wherefore he said, God resisted the proud, but giveth grace unto the humble. When you read it from Amplified Version, you understand it very clearly. It's more than how you read it from this portion. Look at how he rendered it in the Amplified Version. He said, but he, God, gives us more and more grace. What is the meaning of that? That word means power of the Holy Spirit to do what? To meet these evil tendencies and all others fully. Now say Yamina Crane me say, yet yesibia emusu, a yesia enyan, a yesibia bonia semuma, a yes will be 200 Ghana no babeku. Last week 10 million will be soft for 10 million, me say 2 million. A yesia. When you are with your German, Obia Bow shop, what begin a tear the quarter da. What the port to be any more body 7 times, said Bubugu, when you must win infra. So I'm here to let you know no weapon formed against you.
shall prosper,
and every tongue that will curse you in judgment, thou will condemn them. So I'm here to let you, whenever you hear a man of God ministering, God give it more grace. More grace. For what? He's talking about power to meet. Power to meet this evil tendency and all other things. Power. So then when we talk about grace, we are talking about power. May you receive grace, power to live long, power to marry in the name of Jesus Christ. So the place where I read to you, let's go back. Jesus said, look at what I've done. John chapter 13 verse 15, look at what I've done. I want you to do the same thing. If you say you are following me, amen. For I have given you an example that ye should do as I have done to you. Now, when you read this portion, you may not understand it clearly, but let's move upwards to third. John 13, verse 3. You understand what he said, what he was saying, that this is what I have done, so do the same thing. Let's go and see what the man was doing in order to attract power that nobody had ever lived like Jesus before. Obi bien obi asia, obi transia. 2 million were there, but so bad compared to Jesus. Nobody. 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 But look at what he did. Jesus, knowing that the Father had given all things, not some things, into his hands. Not the family, his hands. And that he was come from God and went to God. Look at what he did. He said, do this thing. If you want to attract favor, if you want to become now unstoppable, unbreakable, untouchable, now indefatigable, then follow this protocol. See what happened. He rises from supper and laid aside his garment and took a towel and girded himself. Ah, this man is going to do what? What is he coming to do? Obama Edebe. Ofa Bukiti, send Sugu Mode, Tau Boni Nasene. Then obey, Quatitin, we are Sapa, Nasa Obeja, and Nabo Rubi. After that, he himself went to where the pipe was or the water and poured water into that basin and began to wash the feet, the disciples' feet, and to wipe them with the towel wherewith he was given. And Bible said that then coming here to the Simon Peter, and Peter said unto him, Lord, dost thou wash my feet? Do know your name? Your name is Rabbi. It means the teachers of teachers. I know many people have a big title. Now, Bishop, Reverend, Colonel, whatever. But you deserve all those big titles. So why should you do this thing? No. Stop, Jesus, stop. See what happened. Jesus answered and said unto him, what I do, thou knowest not now, but thou shalt know hereafter. Look at it well. Let's read together. Peter said unto him, thou shalt never wash my feet. Jesus answered him, if I wash thee not, thou hast no part with me. For in this kingdom, the principle is far different than the worldly kingdom. Those who are superior, they are those who serve in this kingdom. But when you go to the worldly kingdom, those who are superior people, they are being served always. So the way we run in this kingdom is far different than the kingdom in the world. Hallelujah. Now, write this thing down. Write this thing down. Humility. For I told you last week that one of the character that Jesus demonstrated was what? Yeah, was an act of humility or meekness. Yeah, that's one thing that he demonstrated. So today what we are still learning and following and imitating is the habit of Jesus, which was humility or meekness. And write this thing down. Humility, you can write these things on your DP or your status. Humility helps you to handle, now, right now. Without humility, you have placed a limit on your life. You don't need, you might think maybe there is somebody somewhere fighting you. There's a witch somewhere pressing some buttons against you. I'm here to let you know, ladies and gentlemen, in a time like this, without humility, you have placed a limit on your life. And no man of God, no pastor can remove that limitation from you. Why? God resists the proud and gives grace to the humble. Question. If God is resisting you,
and Bishop, Reverend, Colonel,
whoever, stand up and say, I pour oil on you.
Your body will become oily.
But no, nothing will happen to you. Why? Because God has now made a declaration that Satan should stop fighting you. He himself will be fighting you. I pray that grace, rather, will be given to us. So without humility, you have placed a limit on your life. Amen. Look at the man we are serving. Matthew chapter 11, verse 29. Look at him. Let me give you a lot of quotation very fast. Now, look at him. Take my yoke upon you. Yeah. And learn from me. Learn from me if you want to go far. For I am meek. You call me your Lord, 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 Lord. I am your Lord. I am meek and lowly in heart. And ye shall find rest unto your soul. So if you are born again believer and you want to have rest unto thy soul, the remedy is be meek. Be humble. And you have rest. Because God will always make sure he will protect you and guide you and lift you no matter what they will do against you in this life. You are blessed today. Let me push it forward and give you another scripture. John chapter 13 verse 15. John 13, 15. For I have given you an example that ye should do as I have done to you. What was that example? Philippians chapter 2 verse 5. Philippians chapter 2 verse number 5. Bible says that, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. I like it, New Living Version. Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. Which kind of mindset? Give me the sixth verse. Bible says that, though he was God, he did not think of equality with God as something to cling on. Now, let me tell you something. One of the things that is killing this generation is repetition. What you are known for. That's what killing many generations in this time. And Jesus said that though Jesus Christ was God, he did not think of equality with God as something to cling to. Look at the seventh verse. Bible says that instead, he gave up his divine privilege. He took the humble position of a slave and was born as a human being when he appeared in human form. Look at the eighth verse. Bible says that he, Jesus, your Lord and your King, King of kings and Lord of lords, the lily of valley, the rose of Sharon, the Alpha and Omega, he humbled himself in obedience to God and died a criminal's death on the cross. And as he decided to go on that direction, remain humble on everything, in every way, look at the outcome. That thing is coming to your life right now. Bible says, therefore, God elevated him. Some of you here, whether they like it or not, you are a star in your family. Can I pray for somebody here? This year, God will shock you with something that you shed tears of joy. A time is coming. You give $100 million as your tithe. Receive that special grace right now. I pray for somebody there in your family. You will be counted among the stars over there. And no matter what happened, nobody can destroy your destiny. One day, God looked at David when he became a king. He sat down, lay down prostrate, started singing. Me cry, me nehwan, na di eni me fi. Says so for be a pejana. No, I know him. Me na ba o ba be pa. Me tu kwa unim unim suba. You know everything about me. Unim suba pa. Say inyesa me perfect. Then so I don't know dumb sir. I don't know when it come on sir. My order. Nyangu post no. There is a man after my heart. And when you read the book of Psalm, he said, if you make attempt to touch David, I, the Lord, will beat you. The first time I saw that verse in the Bible, that God said, I will beat someone who would make attempt to touch David after this service. Because of that humbleness, that meekness, that has been imparted to your human story. Whoever will make attempt to touch you, heavens will touch that person. Whoever will make attempt to destroy your life, heavens will destroy that person. And if anybody joined any gang to destroy your life, heavens will fall upon that person. Because God himself will fight your battle for you. See, my case is different. Hallelujah. Therefore, God elevated him to the place of highest honor and gave him the name that above all other names, on the channel of humility.
May we remain humble anywhere we go. Shout a big hallelujah. Can you fail or can you go down? 1 Peter chapter 5 verse 5. I like this verse so much. 1 Peter chapter 5 verse number 5. Can we read together? Likewise, ye younger, submit yourselves unto the elder. Yeah, all of you, be subject one to another and be clothed with humility. Ladies and gentlemen, I said something like, when he says somebody is humble, humility or meekness is not a gift. Amen. It's not a gift. No. You clothe yourself with humility. You do it. You clothe yourself with humility. Why would the ambrosia to me fra? So it is your own duty, your own work. It's not a gift. Hallelujah. He said that be clothed with humility. That means that another verse, New Living Version says, dress yourself. Amen. With meekness. He said each other in humility. Yeah. Yeah. And all of you serve each other in humility. God opposes the proud, but favors the humble. May God always favor you in the name of Jesus. Look at the sixth verse. And he says that, so humble yourselves under the mighty power of God. And at the right time, sister, today may be your time, but tomorrow may be my time. And never it my order, but it's not ever my daddy. Bible says, every pepper muno. When God visits your neighbor, it means he is in your neighborhood. I see God visits somebody here, visiting you and surprising you. Shout a big amen. Two, write this thing down before we close. Knowing what to do, put you in command of your needs in life. Say, before I came to minister to that, you should clothe yourself with a garment of humility. If you know it and you do it, that's what will help you to have command over any other things in this life. That's why there's a saying that knowledge is power. Knowledge is power. Knowing what to do puts you in command of your needs in life. Knowing what to do. As a born-again believer, and one of the requirements is saying that we should remain humble. We should be meek, because the meekest is the greatest. Write this thing down. God will never lift any man beyond his proven level of humility. Where we are standing is not our level. So until said, you better bring once on your mind. So enter, bear what she says you do. If we remain proud in his sight, no. God will never lift any man beyond his proven level of his humility. So if you have been praying, doing fasting and prayers. Dry fasting, stop leka, and do what the word of God is saying. Because if you are believing God for us, now a high weight lifting, then make sure you be also ready to be remain meek, no matter how, and no matter what happened. It's a serious key I've given to you, serious key. And anyone with that kind of virtue, they say if you are Bobignano. They said, curses, Yari, they are the Adibibet, Achia Falso, and they're possible. On what the idea to a city as well. Wahumbra Sinti or Subekasa, and my dinner go back to the sender. Kaame Kasepa. Are you blessed today? I like it. Numbers chapter 12, verse 3. Numbers chapter 12, verse number 3. Numbers. Bible says that. Now Moses was, now the man Moses was very meek. Above all the men which were upon the face of the earth. Okay? He was what? Not, he wasn't meek. He was very meek. Today, you can't even advise a young person who is 20 years. Nobody advised me. No. You can't. Nobody advised me. I know what I do. I know. That's why we can see a lot of problem going on in the system now. Yeah. One day, a sister told a certain woman, an old woman, who Because the senior bank and send a wife a moving. Bye bye. We need to remain humble at all costs. That would be maybe that could be your secret in this life. That man who was very meek. Look at another version for him. Exodus chapter 11, verse 3. Exodus chapter 11, verse number 3. That man who was meek, very meek. And the Lord gave the people now favor in the sight of the Egyptians. Moreover, the man Moses was very great. The man who was very meek was very great. I pray that you be very great in the name of Jesus. The man Moses who was very meek was very great. Some of you, if you, I have been saying something, that humility makes you attractive. Have I said it before? So what makes a woman, a man, handsome or attractive is humility. It's not makeups. So if you are here and you are going to marry, I'm giving you a requirement that will help you. Go for a woman, not who is beautiful, in quote, a man who is handsome. I'm telling you, go for a man or woman who is humble. It will help you. It will help you all the days of your life. Hallelujah. You are blessed. Amen. The meeker you are, the higher you fly. Let's stand up and pray. The meeker you are, the higher you fly. I want us to pray for somebody here that God is going to cause you to fly higher and higher no matter what happens. So from this, I'll put it in your mind. The meeker you are, the higher you fly. That means that God himself will make sure he will give you more grace in that department so that you can fly higher and higher and higher. Are you here to pray with me? Shall we stand up feet and begin to say a big thank you to God? Just say a big thank you to God. Thank God for granting you special grace to remain humble at all costs, no matter what happens. Say thank you to God for granting you special grace to remain humble, no matter what happens. Pray for that grace to remain humble. Grace to remain humble at all costs. Pray. Grace to remain humble. Grace to remain humble. Zechariah chapter 9, verse 9. Oh, grace to remain humble. Le katarabayado, le katarobo sata, liandorobo kataraba, ramayandorobo sakata, liandorobo le kataba. Zechariah chapter 9 verse 9. Can we pray? Le katarama sata, liandoro kataba, unity verse. Ramakatorobo sata, liandorobo sakata, ramayandorobo sata, liandorobo katorobo, liandorobo kataba zia, zizitaba. Jesus. When I read this version yesterday night, I was so happy. I thought about it. I kept on thinking about it. Look at how he rendered it. Let's read together. 1, 2. Rejoice, oh people of Zion. Talking about the church of Jesus Christ in the New Testament. Shout in triumph. Oh, this week you are going to shout in triumph. This year we will shout in triumph. Then let's hear what he's going to say. Oh, people of Jerusalem. Look. What should we look? Your king, not your servant, not your slave, not your boy, not your girl. Your king, if you like, I say, your king of kings is coming to you. Wow, let's see how he's coming. Look at how he talk about Bible. He is what? He is righteous and victorious. May you remain righteous and victorious. May you not live your life like an armed robber in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We are saved by grace. And because of that, many people are living their life anyhow. No. If the Spirit of Christ is working inside of you, you live after the order of that life. He is righteous and victorious. And see what happened. Yet, he is humble. Riding on a donkey. Riding on a donkey. Yet, have you seen it? Yet, with all the rank, with all the height where he's standing, yet he is humble. Sir, it's available. Let's do a hand like this. Say, Father, today we clothe ourselves with the spirit of humility, with the spirit of meekness. Sister, say it. We are doing something. Now, we are made to do the word, not to just obey the word. Say, Father, I clothe myself. Kando Robosa. I clothe myself with the spirit of meekness. With the spirit of meekness. Prophesy. Meekness is not weakness, but it is power under control. Meekness is not weakness, but it's power under control. Lekatorobo shata, liandoro katama, ramayandorobo, ramakatama, ziandorobo, liandorobo kata. Meekness is not weakness. Ramayandorobo, liandorobo, lekatorobo, ramasandorobo, liandorobo kata, ramayandorobo shata raba, liandorobo shata. Jesus. When you are brought up from an environment where they are not matured in the things of God, they see it in this way. This how when they decide to remain meek, that's why they define you. Meekness is not weakness, but it is power under control. That means it doesn't matter how level God will place you, nothing will shake you, nothing will change your body temperature. These are the things you put them on your phone. Then you stop writing. She never drive. Right, meekness is not weakness, but it is power under control. No matter how level God will lift you, nothing stops, nothing change your body temperature, nothing. You remain under perpetual control. Some of you here, God is going to move you to highest level. The more they fight you, the more God will elevate you. Hallelujah. Let me give you a sermon before we leave from this temple. 2 Kings chapter 7 verse 5. 2 Kings chapter 7 verse 5. So at twilight they set out for the camp of the Arameans, but when they came to the edge of the camp, no one was there. 6. For the Lord had caused the Arameans army to hear the what? To hear what? Now give me King James verse, let me see. 6. For the Lord had made the host of the Assyrians to hear a noise of chariots and a noise of horses. These lepers were just coming. And while they were coming, God amplified their feet. And the noise caused their enemies to scatter. This week, anywhere you step, the noise will scatter your enemies. Whilst we are speaking this, we are praying this prayer, you can take your project offering, amen. Bless it, then you put it in the bowl that is available to you. Begin to pray the Lord. May my voice and may my feet come like a noise. Come like a noise. In the name of Jesus, whilst you are praying, say, Father, thank you for amplifying my feet. Anywhere that I stand, may my feet scatter the works of the enemy. May my feet scatter the works of the enemy. I sanctify all the project of faith in the name of Jesus. You can bring your project of faith. Rahwash your praying. Pray. Yandorobo Shataraba. Ramayana Rasadaba. Just prophesy. Say, Lord, thank you for amplifying my voice. Ramayana Masata. Matthew chapter 23, verse 2. Prophesy in the name of Jesus. Lekatarabaya. Ramayadorobo Shakatabaya. Ramayadorobo Shataya. Amplifadas. Lekataba. Ramayadorobo. Ramayadorobo Shaka. Ramayadorobo Shaka. Jesus. Now, I wanted to cast revelation before we close the service. Cast revelation from what you are going to read. 1, 2. The scribes and Pharisees sit on Moses' seat of authority. 3. So observe and practice all they tell you, but do not do what they do, for they preach but do not practice it. What's the meaning of that? Yes, Mr. Chum said, and Sema, Ombekabia, Omusuba, Mamunfolo, Ned Ombekano, Muniach, if we say Moses, the Kudansu, and Omote. I draw revelation from this portion that we are not seated on the seat of Moses. We are seated on the seat of Jesus Christ. To a seat, demons can be and then the other can be demons obey your words. Let's do your hand like this. Say, Father, any satanic and demonic activity against my health, my business, my children, my family, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, as I open my mouth, I bind them. Sir, once you are praying, if you brought your tithe, you can come forward. Once you are praying, begin to bind them. If you brought your tithe, you can come forward right now. If you brought your tithe, come here. Say, Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we stand in authority of the seat of Jesus against force of darkness. You are blessed. You can go and sit down. You are blessed. As you put it inside, you are already blessed. May the windows of heaven open for you. May the windows of heaven always open for you. May you enjoy windows of heaven. So begin to pray. Begin to exercise authority. Begin to exercise authority in the name of Jesus. Begin to exercise authority over satanic powers, demonic powers, witchcraft powers in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, Ramayadoro Bokata, Yamarobo Sata, say in the name of Jesus, Christ of Nazareth, I say authority over satanic and demonic activity, satanic and demonic agenda, which God manifests. We bind them in the name of Jesus, we frustrate them in the name of Jesus, Yandorobo Sataya, Yandorobo Katara. Exodus chapter 12, verse 13. Leka Toroba. We are the king of verse. Leka Toroba. Ramayadorobo. Ramayadorobo Shata. Ramakataba. Exodus chapter 12, verse 13. Jesus, our last test. And the blood shall be to you for a token upon the houses where ye are. Life is spiritual. And when I see the blood, the spirit of now, the angel of death, when he sees the blood, it will pass over you. And the plague shall not be upon you to destroy you. The virus and whatever can never be upon you to destroy you. When I smite the land of Egypt, in the olden day, they were made to obey the law or the word. But in New Testament, we are made to do the word. These are for the only, we say it, then the effect will come to pass. See, Father, I cover my whole life. My children, my business, my life, our nation Ghana, our church, with the blood of Jesus. Begin to prophesy. Sister, say it. The name of your children. Can you mention the name of your company? Can you mention the name of your wife? Can you mention the name of your husband? Can you mention the name of everything that you have, including your house? Including your house. There will be no fire outbreak. There will be no fire outbreak. In your house, in your office, in the name of Jesus, cover them with the blood, 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 in the name of Jesus, cover them with the blood, cover them with the blood, cover them with the blood, cover your house, cover your body, cover your liver, your kidney, your heart, your eyes, your brain, your bones, your prostrate, cover them with the blood. Free Solomon. I cover myself with the blood of Jesus. I cover my wife, my children. I cover my workers, my executives, my members, my congregation with the blood of Jesus. We cover ourselves with the blood of Jesus. We cover ourselves with the blood of Jesus. We cover ourselves with the blood of Jesus. Jesus, it is well with you. May the rain of blessing fall upon your life. God said, must go and declare blessing upon the children of Israel. And I, the Lord, will come and confirm it. It is well with you. You won't die by accident in the name of Jesus. No virus can locate your body. No infection can locate your body. You are covered with the blood of Jesus. No curse, no fetid priest, no satanic oracle can drop your destiny down. Because you are covered. When they show up, they will not see you. They will see the blood of Jesus Christ. When they show up in your working place, they will see the blood of Jesus. When they show up to damage the lives of your children, may they see the blood of Jesus. When they show up in your bedroom, may they see the blood of Jesus. You are covered by the blood, and nothing can stop you. If God be for you, who can be against you? Jesus' name you are blessed. Amen. Sit down and clap your hand for Jesus.